My presentation is over Immaculee Ilibagiza. Immaculee Ilibagiza. Immaculee Ilibagiza. Immaculee Ilibagiza. In Rwanda, it's traditional for the parents to give a different surname to every one of their child. It depends on how they're feeling at the moment they are born. Ilibagiza means shining and beautiful in body and soul. Wow. Immaculee grew up in Rwanda. Rwanda. There are three kinds of tribes in Rwanda. Hutus, Tutsi, Twa. She is a Tutsi. Hutus are the dominant race. Race. They are darker, have a pudgier nose, and are shorter. Tutsis are more Western looking. They're taller, have a skinnier nose, and they're a lot lighter skin. Twas aren't important in this story. Immaculee was one of four. There was Aimable, Domashine, Immaculee, Viani. Immaculee was very well off. She lived in one of the biggest houses in her province of Kabui. In 1993, she went to college in an all-girls school. In 1994, she returned home from college because the genocide was about to break out. She went home to her family, and they told her to go into hiding so she wouldn't be raped or killed. They thought they could fend for themselves. She ended up staying in their pastor's house, Pastor Muzini. He hid 8 other girls in a bathroom.
Not this kind of bathroom. Not this kind of bathroom.
This kind of bathroom.
There were 9 girls in one bathroom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
She hid there for 3 months with 8 other girls. Not even Pastor Muzini's children or wife knew that they were in that bathroom. So they lived off of scraps that their family had left over from dinner. The only thing that was concealing the bathroom was a wardrobe that didn't even fit the whole door of the bathroom. Hutus had raided the house dozens of times and they never found the bathroom.
Wow.
I heard the killers call my name. They were on the other side of the wall, and less than an inch of plaster and wood separated us. Their voices were cold, hard, and determined. She's here. We know she's here somewhere. Find her. Find Immaculee. There were many voices, many killers. I could see them in my mind, my former friends and neighbors who had always greeted me with love and kindness, moving through the house carrying spears and machetes and calling my name. I've killed 399 cockroaches, said one of the killers. Immaculee will make 400. It's a good number to kill. I cowered in the corner of our tiny secret bathroom without moving a muscle. Like the 8 other women hiding for their lives with me, I held my breath so that the killers wouldn't hear me breathing. Their voices clawed at my flesh. I felt as if I were lying on a bed of burning coals, like I'd been set on fire. A sweeping wind of pain engulfed my body. 1,000 invisible needles ripped into me. I never dreamed that fear could cause such agonizing physical anguish. Immaculee prayed the rosary every day. She said she thought that the 8 other women thought she must be crazy because she kept talking to Mary. They all ended up surviving 3 months worth of genocide and dozens of raidings of the house. The Hutus knew they were in that house, but they couldn't find them. Immaculee ended up going to a French camp where she reunited with Aimable, the only member of her family that had survived. Domashine, her favorite brother, was murdered in the street. Viani was also murdered along with her mother, who was raped and killed in front of her father, and then her father was murdered. She had lost almost everybody in her family. She is currently a public speaker and going around telling her story of her survival. Immaculee Ilibagiza is awesome.
Rwanda, Rwanda, yeah, yeah. Rwanda, Rwanda, yeah. They said many a call, a few were chosen, but I wish some wasn't chosen for the blood spilling of Rwanda, yeah. They said me shaki shaki na Bendigo, Thrown in the fire, but you never get burned. But I wish some didn't get burned in Rwanda. They said the man is judged according to his works. So tell me, Africa, what's your worth? There's no money, no diamonds, no fortunes on this planet that can replace Rwanda. Rwanda, Rwanda. These are the cries of the children. Anybody hear my cry from America? It's the United States of America. Then why can't Africa be the United States of Africa? Rwanda, Rwanda. And if England is the United Kingdom, then why can't Africa unite all the kingdoms and become the United Kingdom of Africa? Rwanda, Rwanda. Rwanda.